described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
New Dimension Media presents Drive Through History, New York and the Revolutionary War.
Philadelphia and Boston get the lion's share of the Revolutionary War tourists. Virginia gets its share too. But somewhere down the line is New York and New Jersey. And while it's important to see the big stuff, I think you're going to find some jewels with me as I drive through New York.
Welcome to Drive Through History. Today, I'd like you to join me while I visit some important historical locations from the Revolutionary War era in New York City. I gotta admit, for a guy from Texas, this place is about as foreign feeling as things get here on U.S. soil. I'm a little bit out of my comfort zone. I'm just not a big city guy. I like to see cows grazing. I have friends named Bubba. But me and my trusty Jeep are here to explore the urban canyons and find the remnants of old New York, a New York from long, long ago. Wouldn't that be Old York?
A title says Old York, ? Over a map of the area at the time.
Flush with victory after driving the British out of Boston, George Washington was batting 1,000 as he prepared for his next big showdown. He was 1-0. People were excited. There was great support for the war effort. The Continental Congress had just signed the Declaration of Independence, and we were winning. And everybody loves a winner, right? Well, not everyone. New York was not Boston, and it's thought that perhaps as many as half or more of the people living in New York were loyal to the king. It was a city divided against itself.
He walks near a sign that says Battle Path and climbs stairs lined with flags up a hill. At the top, by a monument.
This is Battle Hill on Long Island, now home to one of the most beautiful cemeteries in the whole country. While not the home to a major battle in the American Revolution, it still nevertheless is honored as an important site in the Battle of Long Island.
He stops by a statue.
Contains this shrine to liberty.
He walks on.
After they left Boston in defeat, the British Army and Navy spent a little time chilling out in Canada, and then after a few months, moved out under new command. British General Sir William Howe came in to replace the disgraced General Gage. Now, the British strategy was focused on capturing New York City, crushing the American army, and forcing a negotiated end to the rebellion. Howe's plan was to negotiate first, and failing that, attack with a vengeance, with massive force. He had assembled the largest fleet of warships on the planet, and his brother, Admiral Richard Howe, was in command of them.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.